Hello, dear learners. Today we are going to talk about the collinomimetic alkaloid. The collinomimetic alkaloid, as you all know, it is cholinergic agonist, or it is collinomimetic, it is also called as, or it is parasympathomimetic. Okay, so the classification, the drug which we are going to talk about is pilocarpine nitrate. So you can see here, the next thing is the classification of cholinergic drug or cholinomimetic or parasympathomimetic drugs, for which I have already uploaded the video for the trick to remember the classification of cholinomimetic drug. Amongst these, the pilocarpine, as you can see here, it is an alkaloid which is cholinomimetic alkaloid, okay, and it belongs to the class direct acting. Okay, so since direct acting, it is direct acting drug, so how it is going to act, we have seen it in the video of neostigmine. The direct acting drug means the an acetylcholine also, you can go through that videos. So acetylcholine, we have seen direct acting and indirect acting ka two diagrams. So direct actings are nothing but they are acting directly on the receptors. Which receptors? Cholinergic receptors, that is muscarinic receptor. So this pilocarpine acts directly. Now we are going to talk about the pilocarpine structure, IUPAC, properties, uses, official preparation and brand name. So next thing is pilocarpine nitrate, coming towards the properties, as you can see here in the picture, it is colorless or white color powdered, which is crystalline in nature, and it is odorless, and its active form is dextrorotatory form. Okay, then solubility, it is freely soluble in water as well as organic solvent alcohol, but it is incompatible with chlorhexidine acetate, okay, phenyl mercuric nitrate and benzalkonium chloride, and the storage, it should be protected from the light. So pilocarpine nitrate, you are supposed to remember only one important thing about pilocarpine, on which the question is asked in the exam, that about its use. It is a drug which is a cholinomimetic drug, direct acting cholinomimetic drug, which is used in treatment of glaucoma. The major use is, it is used in treatment of glaucoma. Next, you can see here the pilocarpine ka structure. Okay, now this structure also no one asks you in the exam, and not even IUPAC. Only the thing which you should know with respect to pilocarpine, that it contains imidazole ring. Okay, so imidazole ring containing drug is pilocarpine from the cholinergic drugs, which belongs to imidazole alkaloid, and it is used in treatment of glaucoma. So these two things you should know. Next, we will move towards the action and uses. Now, how it is used in treatment of glaucoma? Since it's an alkaloid which is stable, very much stable to acetylcholine esterase. Now, why it is stable to acetylcholine esterase? Since it is direct acting, okay, it is direct acting cholinomimetic. Inka function hi ye hai ke ye receptor pe jaake attach karte hai and acetylcholine ke jaisa hi effect produce karte hai. तो एसिटाइलकोलीन क्या इफेक्ट प्रोड्यूस करता है, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन द वीडियो ऑफ एसिटाइलकोलीन, यू कैन गो थ्रू दैट. एंड सिंस इट इज कोलिनोमाइमेटिक, इट विल प्रोड्यूस द सेम इफेक्ट्स एज दैट ऑफ एसिटाइलकोलीन, एंड इट इज क्वाइट स्टेबल टू द हाइड्रोलिसिस बाय एसिटाइलकोलीन एस्टरेसिस ऑल्सो. नाउ कंपेयर टू एसिटाइलकोलीन एंड इट्स डेरिवेटिव, इट इज फार लेस पोटेंट, इट इज अनचार्ज्ड एंड पेनिट्रेट्स द CNS. CNS penetration is there. Now here you can see that it exhibits muscarinic activity, and the primary use is what? It is used in ophthalmology. So this is the characteristic thing of pilocarpine, which you should always remember, that it is used in ophthalmology. Now what action it produces? It produces meiosis, okay, meiotic effect it is having, okay. And this, as you can see here in the picture, see, this is the normal pupil, okay, this is the constriction of pupil or contraction of pupil you can call, and this is dilation of pupil. Now this black color spot you can see, okay, this is constricted here, which has become smaller in size, and this is dilated. So this dilated pupil, the condition is known as mydriasis, the effect is known as mydriasis, and here the constricted pupil, the effect is called as meiosis. Okay, so this is the eye which is treated with pilocarpine. This is normal eye, okay, and this is the eye which is treated with lytic, okay, parasympatholytic. The example is representative example is atropine. Next we will move towards the actions of pilocarpine. So it is having the same actions as that of acetylcholine. You can see here the image is also same, okay. Since the presence of receptors here are marking the making the thing like M3 M5 जो है ये odd है, M1 भी odd है, तो ये odd है तो ये stimulatory है, and M2 M4 ये even number है तो ये inhibitory है nature में. So as you can see here M2 receptors जो है, जो कि even number के receptors है, सिर्फ M2 receptors ये heart और blood vessel पे present होने के वजह से heart पे ये inhibitory action दिखाता है, and blood vessel पे ये inhibitory action दिखाता है. And other as you can see here, it is eyes, okay, lungs में bronchoconstriction करता है, GI में peristalsis increase करता है, secretions increase करता है, bladder, salivary gland, okay, सारे इस पे stimulatory effect है, क्योंकि odd receptors, odd number के receptor present है. And here heart and blood vessel, it is responsible for vessel dilation, okay, vasodilation, because of which blood pressure falls. And heart पे ये it is responsible for decreasing the heart rate as well as force of contraction. And next we will go here, this is the reaction mechanism. Now this thing is also not asked in the exam, but this thing will tell you that how pilocarpine is primarily used in ophthalmology and what is the effect produced. So this is depicting the mechanism. So this is the description, you can refer it for writing the answer, but the diagrammatic presentation we will see, and at that time I will explain you with the help of diagram, it will be more clear to you this explanation. Okay, so we will move towards the diagram. Now here this is the diagram for the mechanism, like how it is responsible for constriction of pupil. Now here you can see this one, it is muscarinic receptor, okay, this is the pilocarpine which is getting attached. So when pilocarpine binds to muscarinic receptors and activates, it binds to G protein, okay. Now this G protein, as you can see here, G protein, as you all know, it is having the subunits alpha, beta, gamma, okay. So this GTP is binding to G protein and the GDP is getting removed. Now here what will happen, from muscarinic receptor this G protein receptor will get separated, and alpha subunit will get separated, and beta and gamma subunit will go together. Now this alpha subunit which has separated, this alpha subunit is responsible for activating, or it is responsible for interacting with phospholipase C and PIP, that is phosphatidyl inositol biphosphate complex, and this complex further will break down into two, that is IP3, okay, and DAG, that is diacyl glycerol and inositol triphosphate, okay. Now this inositol triphosphate will interact with the endoplasmic reticulum of the membrane, and it is responsible for releasing the calcium. Now this IP3 and DAG are secondary messengers. This IP3 is going to react with the endoplasmic reticulum of the membrane. This cytoplasm, if this is interact with the endoplasmic reticulum, and it is responsible for releasing the calcium. Now this calcium which is there, it will in turn bind to a protein. The name of that protein is calmodulin. and it will form a calmodulin calcium complex. Now what is this calmodulin? Calmodulin is a protein which binds to the calcium. It is having basically two domains. That means you can understand it like the way two sites wherein two calciums will bind, and it is responsible, this calmodulin is responsible for phosphorylation of myosin as well as the activation. Now this calmodulin calcium complex, it will do what? It will allow myosin activation and the interaction to occur, and then further this calcium calmodulin will bind to cal-desmon. Now what is cal-desmon? Cal-desmon is also a protein as that of calmodulin. And what is the function of cal-desmon? It is called as calmodulin binding protein and actin binding protein, which is responsible for contraction of smooth muscle. Okay, so this further, this calmodulin calcium, when it binds to cal-desmon, this complex, calmodulin calcium cal-desmon complex, is responsible for myosin actin interaction. And this myosin actin interaction will cause the muscle ka contraction. So this is the mechanism involved. Okay. Next, it is used in glaucoma. Okay, it is used in both narrow angle or closed angle glaucoma, as well as wide angle, or it is also called as open angle glaucoma. So it is effective in treatment of glaucoma. Okay. And the adverse effect is what? It is since it has the capacity to enter in the brain, it can cause the CNS disturbances. So basic thing is ophthalmology, which you should remember, and it is an imidazole alkaloid. Official preparation, as you can see, basically ye ophthalmology mein use kiya jata hai, to definitely iska dosage form hoga eye drops. Okay. So eye drops, pilocarpine eye drops are official in British pharmacopoeia, and the combination eye drops, that is pilocarpine and physostigmine. Now physostigmine is also an cholinomimetic only, but it is indirect acting cholinomimetic. So the combination eye drop is what? Pilocarpine and physostigmine eye drop, which is official in BPC, British Pharmaceutical Codex. As you can see here, pilocarpine eye drop IP 2% weight by volume is manufactured under the brand Pilocar or Pilocar, you can call it as. Okay, next thing is the brand names. Now these are also important. So as you can see here, there are various images, like this is Pilomax. Okay, this is Pilocar. Okay, this is Pericar, this is Carpcap, Pilo, Carpinol, Pilocar. Okay, so these are various brands and all are eye drops. So here you can see Pilodrop, Pilorin, Carpine, Locarp, Pilocar, Carpinol, Pilagan, Carcap, Pilo, Pericar, Pilopress I. These are various brands of pilocarpine. So here with this we finish with pilocarpine nitrate, for which you are supposed to remember that it is primarily used in ophthalmology, which is a direct acting cholinomimetic drug, and it is cholinomimetic alkaloid, which is nothing but imidazole alkaloid. Thank you.